So what do you remember from the day that you had to leave Darfur?
Okay, what I remember to leave Darfur, happiness, the clashes between us and the government. The government began to take the guns, to distribute guns to other people in order to come to display or to kill the black people. So then happened very low classes. First happened with a robbery. When you move it from place to another, you will suddenly find the people, the robbery, they will kill you and to receive all your passengers or all your tools which you have. Then after that began to burn the areas, villages and areas, every village or the village where the people live or where the black people live, they began to burn. And government, it is still began to move with these cars to attack the villages. And then, so burn us and killed us, and we say this is cannot come. We can see the place where can protect us, because we having the protection, whether between, whether in the government also we having any protection. Then we displace it to some of them, to Arab scammers. Some of them they come in charge. I was going with my sister one day before I leave it Darfur. We're going and the government, so suddenly we found a government, they rabbit my sister in front of me. Then the tears come in our eyes. And the other one said, "What are you to cry? What are you to, why are you worrying?" Then he also came to me and began also to rape the man. Then the other said, no. Yes, this is the very dangerous thing which are happening to us, and this thing we can't forget.
Do you think you'll go back to live in Darfur someday?
Yes, I think, but not now, not these days, after the general peace. Right, no, we can't.
No war going
even
on.
Even if we stay here later, 20 days, 20 years or more, then we could stay if this problem didn't solve.